But it's earnings season, so we have Sanghi Industries. That posted a rather good set of numbers operationally, at least. It looked good. The profit number looked very, very good. The margin expansion, that's something that the street liked, though it's coming on a very, very low base. But do understand what's happened in the last quarter and what's the way forward? We have Ms. Bina Engineer, the director of the company, who joins us. Hi, Ms. Engineer. Thanks so much, ma'am, for joining in. Well, on the top line, not much of a growth is what we are seeing. Help us out with the sales volumes for the past quarter. For the first 9 months, what were they? And in fact, what's their target for FY18? I think last time you told us it's at around 3 million tons is what we're targeting. Help us, ma'am.
Yes, the numbers actually have stacked up quite well, because last year, if you see, the sales volume included a substantial amount of clinker sales post-demonetization in that quarter. So in fact, on an overall volume basis, last year in this quarter, we had done highest volume historically. But this time, we've been able to move that volume from clinker to cement. So we've done 17% additional cement sales this quarter. So the cement sales was 6,60,000, and adding other things, the overall sales volume was 7,44,000. So technically, it was lower by 12%, but take away about 2 lakh ton of clinker and add about a lakh of ton of cement to that. So that helps the margin substantially, and it also indicates domestic cement volume growth of 16%. Similarly, the prices also moved up about 11% on a YOY basis, again, on a quarter base.
So, Ms. Engineer, you're saying that overall cement sales were down 12%. Are you trying to tell us that, though cement volumes, as part of that pie, they were up 16%?
No, I'm saying that overall volume was up by 16%. Prices were up by 11%. So, on a total sales basis, I've registered a growth of 11%.
Okay. Ma'am, how exactly is demand looking if you had to, you know, remove the impact of, say, a low base due to demonetization?
Demand is actually picking up quite well. As I said, the first half, there was a sluggish sale in the cement industry as such. And Q3 has registered about 5% growth in the industry as a whole. So today we are on a positive on a 9 month basis. For Sanghi Cement, Q3 has registered a 16% growth in domestic volume term, and which will again move up because now we've begun our deliveries to Maharashtra and Mumbai market through our mini bulk carrier.
So you think that these margins are sustainable for you going forward? 20% plus?
Yes, clearly we had 22% margin without the other income in Q3. And the prices in Q4, which we are realizing, are better than the Q3 averages. So I believe that this is the bare minimum that we should make in the current quarter also.
All right. Ma'am, a quick question in terms of your volumes. For the first 9 months, what kind of a volume number have you done? You told us last time you want to do 3 million tons for FY18. That's on the cards?
More or less, it's on the card. We have done about 18.5 lakh by now. But we could close around 27, if not 3 million ton. And 3.2 is the target for next year.
Okay, and you were talking about that EBITDA, you know, margins you were telling us, but what about an EBITDA per ton basis? What it is? It's at around 1,000 or 1,100 rupees. What is your EBITDA per ton?
We backed up 908 rupees in Q3.
Okay.
And as I said, the prices are appearing better in Q4.
Okay. Just a quick last question then. You had some fundraising which you completed recently via QIP. What exactly will it be used for, and what might your plans be in terms of, say, additional fundraising? You have some capex coming on board?
Correct. So we are putting up an additional capacity of 4.1 million. So we are practically doubling our capacity to 8 million ton. For that, the project cost was about 1250 crores. We have tied up a term loan of 800 crores, and we have raised the QIP of 400 crores. So practically, we have completed the entire funding for the project. We hope to commence work in beginning of April 2018 and complete the project in 2 years.
Okay. All right, Ms. Engineer. Thanks so much, ma'am, for joining and giving us those details. I think the street likes what you're saying. The stock has moved to the high point of the day, saying that quarter four will look much better. They've started deliveries to Maharashtra and the Mumbai market. Before, it was only concentrated in Gujarat. And pricing is improving. Demand is improving. So the street, I think, is reading that as a positive. They're going to be doubling their capacity as well going ahead. Lips are gems. Well, it looks like quite a gem, I think. The stock is up and about. Those numbers look quite good at least the glimpse that we got of them. But on that note, I think we'll slip into a short break. We'll come back. We'll continue our focus on the markets.